Hello, my name is Kim, professor of Kalasangam University, India. Today's topic is second Fourier transform. Let me explain the formulas of a Fourier transform and inverse Fourier transform. And also, let me explain conditions of x of t to have a Fourier transform. Sometimes we call this Dirichlet's conditions. Okay, the formulas of a Fourier transform. In case of continuous time Fourier transform, x over t to x over omega. In this case, my lecture, I explained x over omega equal x over t into exponential to the power of minus L omega t integral dt like this. Then over here, omega equal minus infinity to infinity. X omega, norm x of omega is amplitude spectrum, and angle x omega is, we call this phase spectrum. Inverse transform means we know x of omega. From this, how to know waveform x of t? This is now x over t equal 1 by 2 pi integral minus infinity infinity x omega like this one. Now you can compare this equations, this equations. Now you can now find here 1 by 2 pi is added, and instead of x over t, you can use x over omega. And also here exponential, here minus j omega t, but we are using exponential to the power of plus j omega t. From this we can get x over t. Inverse, we call this inverse transform. X omega is given, how do we get x over t waveform? Also in case of a delay time signal, x of n to x of omega, as we know already, x omega equal is represented by this. Now here, omega equal 0 to 2 pi. In case of a continuous time, omega equal minus pi to pi. In case of delay time signals, omega equal 0 to 2 pi. Sometime, or we use minus pi to pi also we can use. From this also we can use amplitude spectrum and also phase spectrum. Also, inverse transform also, x omega is given, how do we get waveform x of n? From this, we can guess x of n equal 1 by 2 pi, and omega is 0 to 2 pi, therefore x of 0 to 2 pi, x omega, e to the power of plus j omega. Okay? Now, this is inverse Fourier transform of x of omega. This one. Then we can get this time signal x of n. From this, we can get continuous time signal x of t. Then existence of Fourier transform. Now just as I mentioned, in case of a Fourier transform here, discrete case here, also the formula is like this and this. Now you can see here, pay attention to this term, you can see this term does not affect magnitude of this term. Therefore, in order for this term to be converged, we need these conditions. In case of the terms to be converged, have some finite value, also this also some finite, does not go to divergence. We call this Dirichlet conditions. And also, x over t has a finite number of maxima and a minima within any finite intervals. And also, x over t has a finite number of discontinuities within some finite intervals. We call this conditions for x over t to have a Fourier transform. Sometimes we call this Dirichlet's conditions. Thank you so much for your watching. And today I explained the formulas of Fourier transform and inverse Fourier transform. And I have explained the conditions for x over t to have a Fourier transform. Next topic is Fourier transform of periodic signals. Please look forward to next lecture. Thank you very much.